Okay, let's have the qualitative approach to example 64. From the beam shown, by the qualitative approach, construct the influence lines for vertical reaction at B, here, vertical reaction at D, vertical reaction at G, reaction moment at G, shear at E, and bending moment at E. First, for the vertical reaction, again, we remove the capacity of section B to resist vertical reaction. So as a result, this remains solid. So a ruler on this smooth slot is attached. Then we push B upward. We apply positive reaction. So this will rotate about C, and the rest is non-affected, so this portion will remain horizontal. So the influence line would look like this, and the ordinate at B would be equal to 1, so that remains horizontal. Let's call this YA. So by similar triangles, YA as to 7.5 equals 1 as to 4.5. So solving for YA, YA is 4.5 over 7.5, 9 over 15, or, sorry, YA 7.5 over 4.5, 15 over 9, or 5/3. So that's it. That's the influence line for vertical reaction at B. For the vertical reaction at D, so again, like what we did for B, we remove the capacity of D to resist upward vertical reaction. So a ruler is attached on this slotted joint, smooth joint, slotted part. Then if we push this upward, because this remains solid, so as a result, it will rotate about F. It will look like that. Then C will also rise here, and it will rotate about B. This portion rotates about B. So the influence line for reaction D will look like this. So this remains straight. This is unaffected. That's it. Then remember that the ordinate over D is 1, and the rest will be determined by similar triangles. So call that YA, Y sub C, YE, and the rest will be 0. So from the figure, Y sub C has to 10.5 equals 1 as to 6 equals YE as to 3. So solving for Y sub C, 7 over 4, YE would be 0.5 or 1/2. Then in this influence line here, YA, negative YA as to 3 equals 7 over 4 as to 4.5. Or 1.75 as to 4.5. So YA is negative 7 over 6. So that's the influence line for RD. Next, for the vertical reaction at G. So we replace G to be on this slotted part. Again, only the resistance at section G due to vertical reaction is being removed, but there is still resistance to moment because the original joint at C is fixed. So there is resistance to moment. So as a result, if we push this upward because there is resistance to moment, the whole of this portion FG will rise. It remains horizontal. So F will now be here. It rotates about D, C will be here, then it this portion will also rotate about B, so it will look like this, the influence line for reaction at C. So horizontal, then rotates at D, 0 at T, then it will rise like that, rotate about P. So this remains 1, this is also 1, then YA, YE, Y sub C, YA. By similar triangles, YE as to 3 equals 1 as to 6 equals negative Y sub C as to 4.5. So YE is 3 over 6 or 0.5. Y sub C is negative 0.75 or negative 3/4. Then in this diagram here, YE as to 3 equals 0.75 as to 4.5. So YA is 0.5 also. So that's the influence line due to vertical reaction at C. So that's it for this part. So next, for bending moment at G, moment reaction at G. So we replace G by this hinge mechanism. Then we apply positive moment, of course, because there is still resistance due to upward movement at G. So this remains at G here. It cannot rise. It remains at G, because only the resistance to moment is being removed, but vertical resistance or vertical movement remains, there is still resistance to vertical movement. So as a result, when this counterclockwise moment is applied, so because this will not rise, because there is still vertical resistance movement due to vertical movement, resistance due to vertical movement, so this will rotate about F. So as a result, F will go down like this, and it will rotate, this portion will rotate about D, look like that, then C will now be here, and as a result, then this portion will rotate about B this manner. So this will be the resulting figure for influence line due to moment reaction at G. So that's it. Let's call this YA, Y sub C, then Y sub E, Y sub F. Then to determine the ordinate YF, so we imagine that, take note, we are constructing the influence line for moment at G. We imagine that we isolate FG. Remember, this is originally fixed. So if there is a unit load here at F, then we sum up moment about F equal to 0. Imagine we consider FG. So moment at G, or YF, the unit load is at F, moment at G or YF plus 1 times 3 equals 0, so YF would be negative 3. Again, this is moment at G or YF, because the unit load is at F, and we consider only portion FG, so we have here a fixed end at G, then unit load at F. We sum up moment about G equals 0, so MG or YF plus 1 times 3 equals 0, so that's why YF is negative 3. Then the rest of the ordinates shall be determined by similar triangles. So negative YE as to 3 equals negative 3 as to 6 or 3 as to 6 equals Y sub C as to 4.5. So that means YE is negative 1.5. Then Y sub C is positive 2.25 or yes, 2.25. Then in this diagram here, negative YA as to 3 equals 2.25 as to 4.5. So YA would be equal to negative 1.5. So that's the influence line for moment reaction at G. Next, for shear at E, we remove the capacity of E to resist shear. And remember the mechanism to do that. So we replace it by this. Then apply positive shear. So if we push this down, this will slide down and pivot or rotate about D. So C will now be here. And this portion will rotate about B. So it will look like this. Likewise, if we push this upward, then this will rise and rotate about F. Then FG is unaffected, this remains horizontal. And this one will go down, it will look like this. So that's the influence line for shear at E. So this is 0.5 because if we extend this diagram over the support D, this is 1. So 1 as to 6 equals, let us say, YE just to the left as to 3. As to 3, so that's why that's 0.5. So because E is between D and F, that's why this is also negative 0.5. Then Y sub C and YA. So by similar triangles, Y sub C as to 4.5 equals 0.5 as to 3. So Y sub C is, and negative YA as to 3 equals Y sub C as to 4.5. So by the way, Y sub C is 0.75. So that's why we have here 0.75 as to 4.5. So YA is negative 0.5, Y sub C is 0.75, and the rest negative 0.5, 0.5, and this remains horizontal. So that's the influence line for shear at E. Then lastly, influence line for moment at E. So we remove the capacity of E to resist moment, so we replace it by a hinge at E and apply positive moment like that. So this will remain unbreakable, so they remain at that position. So as a result, this E here will rise and rotate about F. FG is unaffected, so that remains horizontal. Then it rotates about this, like that. And this portion ABC will also look like that. So call this YA. By the way, we have AB over L. That's the formula for the ordinate here by the basic approach. So A is 3, B is 3, then L is 6. So 3 times 3 over 6 is 1.5. Then by similar triangles, called it Y sub C and this one YA. So negative Y sub C as to 4.5 equals 1.5 as to 3. So y sub c is negative 2.25. Likewise, in this diagram, ya as to 3 equals 2.25 as to 4.5. So that's why ya is 1.5. So that's it. This is the influence line for moment at E. So I hope that you were able to follow, and constant practice will let you know how to construct influence lines by the qualitative approach.